What's up, guys? Corey here, back coming at you with another video here. I am, what is today? It's Tuesday. Tuesday, all day. Yesterday, I had two. One of them had to cancel, but due to carpet replacement. Anyway, but at any rate, I was happy enough to be able to sit down a little bit too, so it's fine. Yesterday I went out and did a carpet repair. And then when I sent the next person the next text to meet them at their address, they go, "Oh, we're sorry, we forgot. We have to recarpet." So anyway, I didn't do any recording yesterday. I figured I'd just let yesterday go and give myself a break. I'm gonna do four rooms and stairs here. And this is another one of those referral, basically. You know, everything you see me do outside of just a small amount are for repeat and referral clients. The one I did earlier was actually a brand, I did a tile job earlier today and I didn't cover it, and it was actually from a brand new client who just found the information online. And that's rare, because all they did was they found the information, and well, no, actually they found me on Thumbtack, which still had reviews. I used to do Thumbtack in I think 2017 or something, until they went up to about $30 or so a bid. Back then it was $7 to bid a job. So I grabbed a handful more clients there, and then once they went the price up, when they jacked the price up, I quit using them. Anyway, let me show you what I'm getting ready to get started doing here. I think it's holding, the carpet is holding more soil than it looks like it's holding. So I think it's gonna be a pretty big difference here. And I've got different colors involved in the carpet here. I think the lady said there's popsicles and Kool-Aid and stuff. So we've got a little bit of red dye here. Let me show you. All right, here, stairs right there. Got all four bedrooms upstairs. Got this area right here that's red. That should come out. And I feel like when I hit it with ammonia, it's gonna just the red just burst. I'll try to show it up close when I hit it, but I feel like the red is gonna burst and then just kind of go away. Interesting to see how ammonia does red, does dye. I don't know if there's any light in this room. Nope. This one is just, it's dirty. Got one here that is just dirty, but not stained or anything. The other one is dirty with, I think she said Dr. Pepper, I believe. She said Dr. Pepper and popsicles. So I don't know. I don't see any of that being an issue. That should all come out just fine. I just want to show it ahead of time. Just my typical mix. We'll take this out. And then the only thing I will do differently is I will hit it head on with ammonia. When I first begin, I'll coat it with ammonia so it will start to reverse the red and the dye. And it'll probably, I'm gonna clean this room last. So it should probably knock most of the red out of it before I even get here to clean it. Got a closet. I'm gonna leave this out of the video. No point in showing this. And the stairs have a turn in them. I'm gonna vacuum here in a minute. That little blue, that should come out all right. Garden variety dirt there. Anyway, got these stairs here. Harder to cover the cleaning of one of these type of staircases, so I'll just probably do a before and after on this one. Anyway, I think it's 102 outside today. So, and I pulled up, I checked the weather, and I've got a, what am I, hang on a second. What I do this time of the year is I've got a bunch of people that have bought Challenger from me at this point, so I would estimate, when you buy a Challenger, you get on the Christmas card list. So at this point, I believe I've sold maybe a little better than 30 Challengers or so. So I kind of know some of the people I know better than others. So when I pulled up and I checked the weather, it was 102. I took a screenshot of that and I sent it to my buddy that bought a Challenger up in Alaska. So he ought to send back something that says about 75 to 80 degrees later today, whenever he finds that. Last I heard, he was looking to try to maybe move to Texas somewhere because he was tired of the cold. And I don't blame him. You've got to really be serious about enjoying cold weather and live in Alaska. And I don't have the haircut for it. I am not built for Alaska weather myself. I will freeze to death. I dated a girl in Colorado for about 2 years and I thought I was gonna die. It's so damn cold. All right, I'm gonna go out here in the heat. Pulled in the garage, so it should, it's not quite as hot in here. The lights come up, turn off at some point in time, I don't know. Everything is just, I've never really shown anybody around the van here lately. Let me open it all up and we'll take a look around and see how everything is all put in there. It fits. I need more space, but I don't want to pay for more space. I'm frugal. Hang on. All right, this is a 2010 Toyota Sienna is what it is. I've still got the, you know, stupid stuff in here. Like, you know, it was started out as a passenger car, but I don't know if I knew. I never even worked this thing. It's got the TV thing that comes down in here. You probably can't do it one-handed. Anyway, got a TV here that I have no use for whatsoever, but it's there. In here is where I keep all of my my stretching tools. This is what I carry. I'll carry fresh water in this one and in that one sometimes, and sometimes I'll turn that one into a bunch of pre-spray if I want a huge, huge job. Anyway, got my two blowers back here, and in here, I can get it open. A little more carpet, and underneath all of this, I've got I got my furniture moving stuff here. I got my straps for pulling furniture. I've got one power stretcher and four mini stretchers in there. And this guy here is where I carry tack strip and Z-bar inside back. Come around here, look in the back of the van. All right, here we go. Challenger, Mighty Eco 17, heavy as hell, Oric Orbiter. Carry them all three right there. So this guy, I don't remember the last time I pulled it off the van. I've got a church coming up in, I think, about 2 weeks. So I'm going to go ahead and leave it on the van for the church that I've got coming up. And I may just use it there because, you know, I got a lot of money in it and I'd like to get some money back out of it. So I need to use it a little bit if I can. Anyway, that's what we're looking at here. Look around the other side. See what else we got. This other side here, I carry cold drinks and my wife sandwiches and stuff like that. Makes me sandwiches. Here, we've got my carpet tools. In here are carpet irons, and that's just your basic carpet tools here. More fans. This one here is the 18-volt Raleigh fan. I let that blow on me while I'm seaming carpet together, at least in the summertime, so it keeps the heat back a little bit. And I'll always carry spare carpet because I don't just clean carpet. I do a lot with carpet repair and stretching, mainly carpet repair and stretching. I started out as a cleaner and I wanted to know more because I always had an issue when people ask, hey, I need this fixed. Can you fix this? And I would hate to tell them, I'm sorry, I don't know how to do that. Let me see if I can find you somebody that knows more about carpet than I do, and then I'll have them help you, and then I'll probably lose you forever. So, you know, I decided, well, maybe I should just learn carpet stretching and repair. And when I decided to learn it, there was nobody to teach you that. But so I learned how to do it my own way. And then by the time I got to YouTube with it in 2017, everybody wants to tell you how to stretch carpet and when I don't need them anymore. So it's amazing what you get when you run into YouTube. You always know it all. All right, I'm gonna take everything inside and we will pick up the video there. I added a different step here to some of my cleaning. This has been vacuumed really well. It's gonna get vacuumed one more time. But this guy here, a lot of times when people vacuum, they'll miss stuff in the corners. So they just blow everything out of the corners. That way it's in the middle of the room. And when you vacuum, you'll get it. I saw a Fruit Loop in the other room over here. Let's see if I was right. Skip this one here or now. I got a Fruit Loop over here, I believe. Yeah. See? I just saw something here that I didn't notice until now. Chewing gum, right there. Vacuum for that guy there. I'm not gonna cover the vacuum. I'm not gonna cover that. So, sorry about that, but I'll make the video where it's short enough to watch. Isn't that nuts? I got this guy here at Goodwill for, I want to say $5.99, I think is what it says. And the battery, running $100. That's crazy. All right, I'm going to vacuum all this up and be back to do some cleaning. Did the stairs first. All right, I went over here and I sprayed the chewing gum first. You want to soak it like crazy. Trying to get the ammonia underneath it as well. And this guy here, that silly red dye. See how the foam starts turning red a little bit, and it starts breaking down the red. High pH is what takes the color out of the dye. Now, keep in mind, the carpet itself has a dye in it. It's way more resilient. So, you know, if you take ammonia and you put it on the carpet and you start after it with an iron with the intent to take the dye out of the carpet, you can eventually start to reverse the dye in the carpet as well. Not really something you need to worry about so much if you're just trying to get the red out of the carpet. Not really that big of a deal. Nothing to worry about. But, you know, you just need to keep that in the back of your mind when you're trying to perform a dye reduction, that you're affecting the dye in the carpet as well. But it's not truly that big of a deal. You would have to really just about make it your intention to destroy the carpet. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go put ammonia in, they threw it over the wall, whatever it was. Anyway, I'm gonna go put some ammonia in my 2 gallon pump up, and I'm gonna use that to spray that a little more efficiently, a little faster. Dwell time is what I'm looking for anyway right now. So this room's gonna get clean last, but first I'm gonna put a nice even coat of ammonia on all of that right there and let it start doing its magic. All right, here we go. Let me make sure this thing's ready to spray here. It is. Okay, what we've got here, we've got a 2 gallon sprayer with one that is ammonia comes in a 1/2 gallon. So I've got a 1/2 gallon of ammonia, a shot of peroxide, and the rest water. So ammonia is unique in the fact that you can cut it in half and it'll still maintain a pH of 14, which is amazing. So you can water it down quite a bit and still have a really strong product.
could zap the red right out of that immediately. I don't know if you saw that one over there or not, but that was a gimme. That was quick. Normally a trigger sprayer is all I need to apply it with. Boy, that looks even better through the camera lens, doesn't it? It doesn't smell overpowering in here the way I've got it mixed, or maybe the way the wind's blowing right this second. I don't know. But yeah, it even took care of stuff on the wall. Travel. Let me word that differently. I ride hard with a no CRB crew. I hate that crap. It just pisses me off. I don't even like the way CRB is spelled. Anyway, here's another option. You want to clean and agitate real quick, like with a different tool. How else would I put that? I'm not just a member of the anti-CRB club. I'm the president. Put it that way. I'm the president of that club. And people would vote for me like you wouldn't believe in an anti-CRB club. Finding some blue over here. Amazing. How many different colors I'm finding in this carpet here. Now, I believe the main reason why people that clean carpet don't always get the carpet to look good, don't always get it clean, is because they don't spend an adequate amount of time applying the pre-spray correctly, enough, or strong enough. That's got a lot to do with the price people pay for their cleaners too. If I was paying what everybody else paid for the cleaner, I might be prone to be a little stingy myself. But I don't. I'm heavy on the product because I buy it cheap, and heavy on the elbow grease because my carpet, my client, my channel, my business. That's why. You know, every once in a while, people will, they'll tune in and they'll watch the show and they'll ask questions and, you know, and I won't answer it because, a lot of people feel like if they ask you a question, they're owed an answer. That's not the case at all. I had an attorney explain that to me one time, that you put people on the bench and you start asking them questions, they don't really have to answer all those questions, you know? So, just because somebody asks you a question doesn't necessarily mean they deserve an answer. You know, a lot of the questions I get are, you know, just to kind of start trouble. All right. I'm going to spin that one there a little bit with this tool. Get it good and ready. Wow, see all that red? Look at that. Lottery. And it's not going anywhere but away, because when ammonia hits it, it goes away. And then there's somebody with a school of thought, well, what if it wicks back? That's what the peroxide is for. That's what the peroxide is for. All right, we are actually ready to start the carpet cleaning process now. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start in this room here. Let that room down there do all it needs to do with its, with it soaking, basically the ammonia soaking in it still. So I'm gonna go bring everything down here, and this is where we're gonna begin. All right, here we are. I'm gonna start this room first here. Anyway, that's where you saw that red wall go. And when I started combing through it with the brush, I brought up all that red, and then it, as soon as the ammonia kind of wrapped around the red, and it just erased the red, took it out. Over here, did a little of the same thing. Now, let's go look over here. Keep in mind, the only thing I've sprayed on is ammonia, so I've got about $1, not about $2.50 at this point, about $2.50. So anyway, this was where all that red was at, and I haven't cleaned it yet, I've just pre-treated it. So your pre-treatment matters for a whole hell of a lot more than the scrubbing does. You've got to know what chemicals to use and where to use them, and got a little experience with that. All right, now, yeah, here, we're gonna try to clean it, but I know the phone's gonna, I've probably been here an hour, and I've probably scheduled three or four jobs at the end of next month. It's a blessing, but it's scary at the same time, because if I twist my ankle or anything, you know, then it makes you a liar. You got to find somebody else to help these people. So hope I can keep up. I've got something been bothering me for a while, so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to give you the abridged version of it right now, and I'm going to leave all the names out, so if there's anybody innocent involved, they're not brought into this. Anyway, I've mentioned before that when I first started on YouTube, I was looking around and I found these guys that were getting abused, something terrible, you know, because they weren't using fancy equipment or fancy chemicals and stuff, so I felt bad. I felt really bad for these guys. So I reached out to them and I befriended them and figured, I'll help these guys all I can. Well, I don't know if I can do the story justice. Anyway, I've known them since 2017. And strangest thing, you know, you truly don't know who you meet online, who you can trust, who you can't. But these guys are out, they don't do so much on YouTube anymore. They're in like those Facebook groups, and it's really one guy. There's two, but there's only one guy that's really the issue. Remember, I had an issue with it one other time. I started being a dealer for Challenger, and then that made everybody mad, so they butted in on that and screwed that up, and finally got all that straight. And okay, I'm gonna let it slide. I'll try to be friends with these guys. So, you know, all that time goes by for like, I was like about 2019 that happened. And then, it looked like that they were continuing to get harassed in these different groups on Facebook. And kind of how it turned out basically was that it wasn't people harassing them. It was one guy in particular going around harassing other guys about how they do their work and what chemicals they use and what process they use. And as it turns out, the two guys that do all of this aren't professional carpet cleaners. They live in an apartment complex and they clean for their neighbors, which is fine if you want to clean with an Oric and play with an Oric and, you know, grab ass around with your buddy in an Oric or whatever, well, you know, whatever makes you happy. But it doesn't give you the right or the ability to tell someone how to run their small business. If you're listening, and I know you are, you aren't running a small business. You are jackassing around cleaning for your neighbors. That is completely different than running a business. So hopefully when I check, and I will, I'm hoping that I see this one individual shut up and quit trying to blast me on these little tiny Facebook groups. Because if I continue to see it, I just might make you your very own video. So for the love of God, please, please shut up, Mr. Dumbass out there. I don't want to do that. It's not in my nature, but all I'm here to do is help people, you know? So anyway, we're going to clean this room now, and we're going to leave that alone, and hopefully that will be enough to solve the new issue I've been having. And I won't have to mention this ever again. Because if I do, it'll be different. It'll be far different. Guys, a lot of equipment from Challenger that I paid for. And basically, what I'm seeing now is this one individual is telling everybody basically to not buy Challenger in a roundabout sort of way because it would benefit me in some way. And I didn't realize it, but apparently there's carpet cleaners that view other carpet cleaners as being more successful than they are, so it makes them angry and you want to try to ruin that. It's weird because, you know, I don't do carpet cleaning for the glory. It's not a glorious profession. I'm damn good at it, but I don't do it for the glory, and I've never claimed to be the best, but what I am is real damn good at it, and I won't make any promises I can't keep. You know, everybody that buys a Challenger gets on the Christmas card list, they get $100 back, they're able to text with questions and stuff, so I'm here for you, but the abuse that I take for it is bothersome at times. At any rate, I don't want anybody to ask me who I'm speaking about in the comments. I'm not going to share that, because what I'm looking for is for this to go away. I'll be right back. The reason why I befriend people all night and I help people is because it feels good to help people, you know. And when you set out to help people, generally good things will happen to you. I mean, I've had to put up with some dumb shit, but generally the best will come to you if you're set out to help somebody. Now, if you set out to destroy somebody and cause them grief and stuff like that, and you wonder why your life yourself looks like complete shit, it's because you're weaving the wrong basket. You're weaving together trouble. You're not weaving together anything that's happy. Yum, just damn near, it's just gone. It just disappeared. Man. Just disappeared. I don't know where it went. It reminds me of that movie Envy, where they had that product, Jack Black had, called Vaporize. Toward the end of the movie, they wanted to know where the dog turds went, and they couldn't come up with any answers, so he was in trouble. Vaporize. You spray aerosol on dog shit, and it goes away. But nobody knew where. All right. There's another little ammonia trick. And keep in mind, when I show you ammonia tricks, I don't make a damn dime. Nobody makes a dime. That's just me passing on some information to you guys. It will help you. It will help you save money. Help you be more successful because you don't have to spend so much money on your product. You show up at a place like this with Red Relief, and look, it used to be like 32 bottles, $32 for a third. $35 about for a 32-ounce bottle of that stuff. And you show up at the job site, you need a couple bottles of that, and before you know it, you either have to charge the people like crazy or you're not making any money. Whereas I spent, you know, a couple bucks so far here treating carpet and cleaning it. Guys that I'm talking about, you know, they're going to remain nameless, and I'm not going to talk about them after this video. I'm not going to bring it up anymore. I just hope that I see some changes going on. Man, there's people out there with using alias names and everything else, you know, and I know who they are. But it doesn't do me any good to share that with anybody, because that's just gossip and bullshit and stupidity, and it doesn't have anything to do with me teaching you how to clean carpet. But if it gets to the point to where I've got these two guys, you know, trying to cause me as much grief as they have been, then it comes to a point to where I feel like I've got to do something to protect myself from slander and bullshit like that. All I'm looking for is peace and quiet on the Facebook groups, and be good. I promise you. Get back to helping people, and that'll be about it, you know? What my intentions were in the beginning. kind of hard to work and talk at the same time. Tend to lose track of what you're trying to talk about or the task you've got at hand. All right, your red was right there. Your chewing gum was right over there in the corner. Well, that's behind us now. This room here, I'm gonna put it in time lapse. I'm gonna do this one here, which I'm gonna start right now. All right, that's what you're looking for. Pretty carpet. Keep in mind that, you know, not every carpet will clean the exact same and you won't have the same results on every single carpet due to variables that you're unaware of. Let's say you use this particular product at this house this day, whatever date that was, you know, the carpet conditions at that house, if it worked well, it worked well at that house. You don't necessarily know that when you take it to another house and you're dealing with a different type of soil and a different type of carpet fiber, exactly how the cleaning is going to respond. So that's why you have to bring a bunch of different chemicals, a bunch of different bonnets, and be prepared to try a bunch of different things, because it's not a one size fits all. You have to adapt and change and grow to the environment that you're trying to fix. So at this point, you know, it's not about how many carpets can I clean and how quickly can I be done. I'm doing this YouTube thing here, so now it's about a legacy. If I can teach other people to do what I do and pass along my particular philosophy, which what I do and my philosophy is different than a lot of people's, then that's what my goal is to do. To teach people how to get the results that I get with the philosophy that I have. You know, my whole philosophy is that if you don't like what I did, I'm not going to bill you for the job that I did. If you're truly unhappy, you come in and look at your carpet and you go, you know, this looks like shit. You know, well, I'm not going to believe you, you know, because, you know, I'm human, for Christ's sakes, it looks great. But if somebody's disagreeable and they want to be abusive and they don't want to pay, it's just one job. So it's been a long time since I walked away from anything without pay. I think the last time I walked away from something without pay, it was somebody offended me and I didn't want their money. I believe that was the last time I walked away from something without pay. Like I said, I do things differently than other people do. I say things different than other people. I use different products than other people. My whole philosophy about life's different than a lot of other people's. You know, for instance, if I'm pleading for you and, you know, and you're incredibly rude, I don't necessarily want your money or your business ever again. You know, That crowd that goes out and they order food at restaurants and they tip a penny, those same people will eventually call you to clean their carpet. And you don't want to work for them. So as soon as you find out who they are, you want to step away. You want to step aside. So it's kind of been, since my last marriage, it's been my goal to find those people that tip a penny and push them as far out of my life as I can. Because they're out there. There's bad people all over the place. And I'm only here to help the good ones. So I have to weed through a lot of different issues in order for me to be here in front of you guys doing what I do. And these guys that I'm talking about, an apology would go a really long way. Not necessarily that we could ever be friends again. That would be stupid on my part to give it a third go around. Apologies help. They kind of put a band-aid on things and allow you to move ahead. So if I can get an apology from this individual that I'm speaking to, that would be good. I did everything I could to help these guys. You know, send them free stuff. The whole peroxide thing, I got them on that. And then, I got them on ammonia and all this other stuff and, helped them out a bunch. Different cleaning philosophies and stuff they didn't know. And now I see them posting things like, don't use ammonia, don't use peroxide. And all of that is a direct shot at myself, which it's just to piss me off. And I do find it irritating. But the last thing I believe I read, which was really, really colorful, it's not just me. There's also another buddy of mine that's involved in this as well. He hasn't been named, and I haven't been named, but this individual that's doing all these colorful things on Facebook right now, he mentioned that he took two of what he thought were good friends and threw them away like trash. He mentioned that in a post. So I don't understand how making a statement that you took good people and threw them away like trash, how does that make you more desirable to be a friend with? He said in his post that he likes to make friends, but anytime anybody crosses him, he'll throw them away like trash, like these two other guys he's talking about. And I'm the one guy he was talking about in that video. And I've never done anything but help the guy, which is odd because he's right here in Texas. And I'm all about 4 hours away from his driveway. And he's on my Christmas card list. So I could go visit. I don't want to go visit, but I could. Now I'm going to put it back in speedy mode and clean this right quick. So I'll have a text come through, take care of that right quick, then come back and clean this, and then we'll go to the last room, I believe. I don't even know anymore. Hey, come. I got those two done. Go have a look.
Awesome.
Honey. Come on, baby girl. All right. One more to go.
Wow.
And that's where the red was at over here. I'm going to talk to my client right quick, and we'll finish this room up. All right. This video is going to be long. I don't see any way around it now. Anyway, I just got to chatting with my client. She just left. I wouldn't let her pay me because I don't believe in being paid until I am done working. I feel like if I take payment like right now, you know, something stupid will happen and I won't get to finish, and then I'll have to give them the money back. So for that reason, I like to be done before I get paid. Anyway, she was telling me that she had... I think she had tried 200 times with one cleaner and one time with the third one. And now I think I'm the fourth guy on the scene here. And I came to her by referral from her boyfriend that I've cleaned for multiple times. She said the first time they no-showed, the second time they showed up several hours late, and she doesn't live here anymore, so it wouldn't work. And then I think she had another company that told her they could do this for $150. And when they got here, they told her, oh, no, $500. Not $150, $500. And that just makes me mad because, you know, that makes the entire industry look like just complete shit, you know, because it doesn't cost that much to get your carpet cleaned. It doesn't. It shouldn't. I like to bill people an amount of money that if I was asked to pay it, I wouldn't have that being an issue paying for it. I don't want to take everybody's money. You know, basically when a company is like that, they want $500 to clean a place this small and this simple. It's because they're not looking for, you know, repeat business. You know, if you're looking for repeat business, you would never try to charge somebody $500 for something like this. You know, they have to pay. First, they want to make as much money as they can. And then, you know, there's all the overhead that the larger companies have that I don't have. I don't have any of that overhead. You know, they have to pay all the people. They have to pay for the storefront. They have to pay for insuring everybody getting there and maybe health insurance if they have it. And have to pay for all the advertising. And then if they're using one of those horseshit services like a home advisor, you know, they have to pay them for the lead. And, you know, so by the time you're done with that, you're not paying to have your carpet cleaned. You're paying for all of these other services that it took them to get to you. And now you owe them because they had the hell charged out of them. Whereas you got a guy like me that came to you without any advertising whatsoever, based on expertise and good feelings alone, is why I'm here. Because people have had success with me before. So I can bill a lot less because I didn't spend a lot of money to get here in this position. So I can do a good job and charge not near as much as the other guys and still do just okay. Real damn okay. heavy soil right here, so I'm putting some money down it. I'm gonna leave the stairs out of the video, but I'm gonna do a recap at the end of what all I was talking about, because there's been so much going on in the time that I've been here, from people scheduling and dropping by and trying to sell me advertising. I deal with a lot of phone calls in the daytime. A lot of phone calls. So it takes me a lot longer to get something done because I'm shooting video, taking phone calls, taking how to do it texts from carpet cleaners all over the country. So it takes me a little longer. See how fast we move. Get to this room here. Yeah, at the end of the video, I'm gonna talk a little bit about the issues I've been kind of having, and I'm gonna leave it at that. So as soon as we get down here. All right, let's groom this out here. Get everything out of the room. Okay, this is perfect. This is wonderful. I can't believe that somebody would actually try to bill somebody $500. I've always had issues, you know, having carpet cleaners as friends because they do stuff like this, like like what the my client just expressed to me. And you know, and I have trouble being friends with somebody that will come out to your house, they'll tell you $150, will come to your house, and it becomes $500. Those people like that are not my friends. So I make it a habit to not reach out to a lot of carpet people because a lot of that goes on and I don't want any of that in my life. You know, so be very careful who you're friends with in the carpet industry. Because there's a lot of snakes. A lot of people don't know that and they wind up paying dearly because they didn't know that.
You know, you're not going to warn everybody. You can't. You can't warn everybody.
You know, you're going to make those people that you're taking advantage of.
You know, a little bit of that also stems from the fact that carpet cleaners, when they're getting started, you know, a lot of times they have something dirty done to them by the people selling them equipment because they'll sell them everything under the sun and tell them that they need it in order to be successful and they don't. So what they'll do is they'll somehow find some way to wave a magic wand and get them financed for, you know, $150,000 worth of steam equipment. It's basically a second mortgage payment to make every month on your equipment. And then when that happens, you're kind of between a rock and a really hard place because even if you don't want to bill people a bunch, you kind of have to, or otherwise you're going to be homeless or without your van and wind up working at Home Depot or something. So, you know, there's other factors involved in why corporate guys do that. But when large carpet companies hire carpet cleaners, they're not looking for a carpet cleaner per se, they're looking for a salesperson. So cleaning carpet is rather easy. Finding somebody that'll do it right is rather difficult. But large carpet companies aren't looking for the best carpet people, they're looking for the best salespeople to go send them to your house to sell you carpet services that they're really not that good at performing. And they staff an office full of them. And when you call, you're the one that winds up paying for all these salespeople to come try to sell you everything they got at the warehouse and on the van. All right, hang on. I'm not going to cover these. We're not going to see these. Video's long enough. Anyway. All right, guys. I hope this video helps somebody. And as far as the individual I'm talking about, I've been quiet for, I want to say, about 6 weeks now. Just kind of watching the situation, being quiet and seeing what transpires. It's not just me. There's another cleaner that had this done to him as well. Not to the point, you know, that money was involved or anything. Just for the fact that, you know, he was friends with these guys as well for several years, as long as I was, and then had that done to him. Basically slandered and all this other stuff. So I just, how do I put this? Basically, this, you know, I'm talking directly to the guy that's doing this because the first thing he did was, you know, I let him know that there was a little bit of an issue with something that he said. So the first thing he did was he blocked me, so I can't reach him. But I know he watches my channel every damn day. Every time I put out a video, he watches it. So I'm talking to you. All I'm looking for is for you to just pretend like you don't know me. Just be quiet. You know, I look. And somebody else looks and they screenshot something that this particular individual said, and it's slanders toward me. And it's basically set out as a screw you, Corey. And I went to a lot of extra effort to be friends with this individual, and only to find out that they're not worthy of being friends with. All I'm looking for is quiet, and I don't want to feel like that you're out there plotting my demise, because I'm not plotting your demise. However, I have left so much out of what I've found by researching these individuals that I don't want to sound like I'm threatening or anything, but there could be another video made about everything I found out. But honestly, I don't have any issue. Anyone, I don't want to do that. I mean, it's stupid. Anyway, I'm looking for peace and quiet out of this one individual that I'm having issues with. And that's really all I've got to say about that. There's so much more, but to talk about it anymore, it could potentially reveal these people to whoever's watching, because there's other people that have had issues with them in Facebook groups too. Now I have. I just was under the impression that they were actually my friends and they were looking out for me. And it turns out they were the ones that were creating all of the hassle and grief that I was taking on. I mean, there's a lot more to the story, but I don't want to get into that. Anyway, it's the end of this video. If you're interested in getting into the carpet cleaning industry and you're looking for good equipment, I can help you. Challenger is $200 off right now. Another $100 off through me. And then I'm there to basically help. I put up videos almost every day. And if you actually buy Challenger from me, then I'm there via text message to help you learn how to clean with it and all the little tips and tricks that you won't get anywhere else but right here. Thanks for watching, guys, and God bless. See you in the next video.
All right, guys.
I'm coming back at you again here. I didn't plan on showing you the stairs, but something just happened that I'm going to show you the stairs. What happened was I took the Oric out to do the stairs. This is the only place I ever use my Oric, is on stairs, rugs, and really small apartments that are really high up, third, fourth floor. So it basically hardly ever gets used. But today when I take it out to use the stairs, it's broken. It gave a little bit of a, I could tell, I think what's going on is the capacitor's out in it. So the start feature is not working. So let me show you how I'm gonna do the stairs. All right, here's the Oric here. And the right here, this when you got it plugged into the juice, this comes on here, turns red. At any rate, I had it plugged in, the button was red. I turned it on and it started to vibrate and cut off, and I banged on it, trying to make it start, and it's just not gonna start. So I don't believe we'll see this guy again in another video. I think I'm gonna probably toss this one. I've got another one at the house that clanks really bad. But like I said, the only place I use them is on stairs. Challenger does everything else. So now, this is what I'm gonna do the stairs with. This is how I used to do it a long time ago. This guy right here. So that's how we're gonna do the stairs. And it is, it does a good job. Problem is that it is more laborious. You gotta bend over while you're cleaning, and it hurts. By the time you get done and you stand up. All right, we'll watch some of this cleaning here. It goes decent, but it's not the way you want to finish your day. But anyway, like I've said in videos before, Oric is for home use. It's really handy if you're a professional carpet cleaner. It's a real cheap way to scrub stuff. It's small, but it's not going to last. I mean, you've got to have several of them, and I should have had a second one on the van with me. Now I'm down to one, so I guess I'm going to toss that one, buy another one used, and just keep a couple on hand.
That's the part that sucks when you stand up. It hurts.
You're bending over and you're cleaning and cleaning and cleaning, and when you stand up, your back tries to lock up on you when you stand up. All right, I'm gonna finish these out right quick and then we'll have a quick look. I just wanted to include that because I'm so damn frustrated. All right, we are done now. We have done the stairs. They're all groomed out. I'm not putting another footprint on them. They've been blown off with the blower. They've been cleaned. They've been groomed. Been vacuumed and all that jazz. So now I'm done. I'm not going to walk up there again. Anyway, there's my poor Oric here. I'm gonna take it out of the van when I get home, leave it there, and put the other one I got on the van. And the other one makes so much damn racket, I don't think you'll ever see another one in the video again, unless I just have to. I mean, you'll never hear it run in the video. The other one clanks so damn bad it's unreal. But you know, they are important to have because I used it quite a bit this morning when I was doing some tile. It scrubbed really well then. That was enough. It expired after I did the tile. It's got enough miles on it at this point. But she is done. All right, I'm gonna close this video out one more time here. All right, I'm finally done. I take all this junk and put it back on the van and go home and upload this video. I hope it helps somebody. I'd already closed the video out, but here I'm talking again. Anyway, I just wanted to include that. Oric is important, but Oric is not a standalone machine. It says commercial on it or industrial or something. It's not the case. If you buy it and you're a homeowner, you know, it'll be fine for you if you're a homeowner or if you're a carpet guy that uses them not so regular, not so often, then they will work fine. If you're a hobbyist carpet cleaner and clean around your place and a couple other buddies' apartments or whatever, they'll do fine for that. But if you want to rely on it for your income, you better have two or three, because one won't get you there. One will leave you without a paycheck. All right, gotta go, guys. Gotta go. God bless.